there's a weird ideology that they're attached to that is it's not tenable. It's not you can't argue it. You know, the idea of ethical treatment of animals, I'm 100% with that. I fucking hate the whole idea of captive orcas. That to me is one of the big
gross
ones. That freaks me the fuck out that we can take these alien creatures that are essentially as smart as us probably and put them in swimming pools and justify it, and that the only time they've ever killed people in recorded history has been in those swimming pools.
Yeah.
They don't kill people in the wild. They kill everything else. They kill whales. They kill dolphins. They kill sharks. They don't fuck with people. In fact, there's been instances where they've saved people.
Mm-hmm.
And yet we've decided to put those. So me and PETA are on the 100% the same page as that. And PETA's retweeted a bunch of shit that I've put up before, which is really weird. They've retweeted a bunch of shit that I've put up about, you know, about orcas. And when I've done that, people are like, you know, he hunts, right? And then it gets, you know, radio silence on PETA's part.
Yeah.
You know, they don't want to comment on that. They just want to support my hate for, you know, orca captivity.
Yeah. You know, I had one of the most, I've been fortunate to have remarkable engagements with wildlife in my life. But 2 years ago in BC, I had one with a killer whale.
Whoa.
And it was wicked. And to this day, I regret not making the decision I'm about to tell you about. But we had been, I'd been bear hunting on the coast, and we were in a boat cruising back to the harbor. And we found two pods of killer whales, three big bulls, and a bunch of cows that were hunting. And we kept, as they would come up, they were chasing salmon, and as they would come up, we would just get closer just to film them or even just to see them. And then they'd go down. And so I don't know if it was just happenstance of where we were, but we came up and we were just kind of waiting for the whole pod to come up. And all of a sudden, just 50 feet from the boat, here comes the huge dorsal fin of this bull, comes right at our boat, bumps into our boat. I'm standing on the in the crow's nest, essentially. I'm on the roof of the boat looking at this thing. He comes up, bumps into our boat, and he just glides his left side all along the boat. So his left pectoral fin is probably under our gunwale, if you will, or under our hull. And so he's just dragging his fin, and he rotates on his side, dragging his dorsal fin along our side, exhales, covering our director of photography, William's face in his spray. And as he's doing this, he goes, he hugs the bow of our boat, and he never, ever breaks eye contact with me. He's staring at me out of his left eye, literally rolling his eye over, and he just cruises all the way around the boat. And I wanted to dive in. And I just wasn't sure. Like, I didn't want to be one of these, you know.
The first guy to die.
I didn't want to be the first guy to die. And I also didn't want to have, like, some sort of shallow water blackout because the water was so cold. So I didn't want to dive in and have all of a sudden, like, I didn't know how my body would react because I hadn't been in the water yet. And so, and then also I was like, I'd watched Blackfish or whatever that film is where they killed a bunch of folks at, you know, in SeaWorld and in BC. And so I was just like, well, what if, you know, there's got to be a first, you know, wolves never killed anyone either. And then, you know, some young lady went jogging in BC and son of a bitch, we have number one.
Well, there's a long history of wolves killing people though in the past.
Yeah. I'm just saying, you know, like, you know, in recorded time, but it was he maintained eye contact, turned, and then just continued on with the hunt. But it was,
fuck. Did you film all this?
Yeah, well, you filmed as much as we could because it happened really fast. But yeah, it was wicked. Absolutely wicked. I mean, literally his dorsal fin is probably 10 feet tall. And it is just, you know, when you drag something against another inanimate object with force, you know, his fin is just, you know, he was just very engaged with the boat.
Is their dorsal fin really that tall?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like, it's got to be 8, 9, 10 feet.
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
I guess it makes sense. They're so big. Fuck, man. I've never seen one in the wild. I've seen dolphins in the wild and I've seen whales in the wild.
Yep.
I've never seen an orca.
Yeah, they're wicked animals. We can't even comprehend what that animal is.
I've always said that if orcas weren't real and Bigfoot was real, we wouldn't give a shit about Bigfoot. Bigfoot would be in the zoo right next to the fucking orangutans. You know, we'd be like, look at the big monkey, big stupid monkey, you know?
Yeah.
But orcas, I mean, they speak in a language that we can't decipher. We don't know what they're saying, but we know that they have dialects. We know that they stay in these pods for life. they have this family organization, yeah. and they all stay in their clan.
Yeah,
they're fucking incredible.
And you've seen Blackfish, obviously.
Yeah,
yeah. I think,
so much as I could watch, I couldn't watch the whole thing. I get angry.
Oh yeah,
I get furious that this is a giant business, that they take these things and they buy them from other organizations. And I've had, you know, I've had real problems with it for a long time. And my friend Phil Demers, he was a trainer at Marineland, and he's been on the podcast many, many times, and he's involved in these constant lawsuits with Marineland. He was a walrus trainer, and he also trained killer whales, and, you know, he's given us some real insight into the horrors of what it's like in Marineland and even in SeaWorld and what they're doing and how they get these orcas and how they're treated and how bad it is for them to be trapped in these environments and how their dorsal fins go limp because they never have to deal with current. Yeah. So the atrophy, the whole thing is sick. It's sick.
Do they still have them now? And killer whales in SeaWorld now?
Yes. Yeah. They still have them. Yeah. Hmm. They can't buy new ones apparently or something like that. There's some weird.
Fantastic.
The whole thing, they can't. I think they could still breed them though. I mean, the whole thing is fucked up, man.
Hmm.
It's just like slavery. If like we had aliens as slaves, we just couldn't. We're like, what are you saying? Oh yeah, I don't know what you're saying, dude. Yeah. Get in the pool if you want to fish. Get in the fucking pool. I mean, that's basically what's going on.
It's gross.
Yeah, it's sick.
Yeah,
it's twisted.
Yeah,
you know, and I just. So that's where me and PETA were on the same page.
Yeah, I think.